In this video, I'm going to show you how to use JMRI and your DCC++ without a computer. We're going to hook it up to a Raspberry Pi. And we're also going to use our cell phone as a throttle. So see how we're going to do this. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. The Raspberry Pi is a small device. It is a small computer that you could hook up your mouse, keyboard, speakers, and an HDMI monitor. This one has Wi-Fi. You could hook up a camera to it, and you could do a lot of things to it. This is a little bit more powerful than an Arduino, and I'm going to show you in this video how to hook it up easily so you can use this to run your JMRI and DCC++. This is all you're going to need for this project right here. You're going to need a mini SD card. You're going to need the Raspberry Pi with Wi-Fi. This right here is a wall wart. It's 5 volts, 2.5 amps, and your DCC++ base station and some tracks. You also need your computer to set it up first because you're going to have to put the program on this mini SD card, and then once you do that, you'll be able to use that as a bootable disk for your Raspberry Pi. And here is the Raspberry Pi with Wi-Fi capabilities and Bluetooth. I have one, a same version, but without Wi-Fi. So you do have the possibility of purchasing this without the Wi-Fi, which I did originally. I have an extra one now. But this is the one we're going to use that has the Wi-Fi on there. And it's all the same. We have 4 USB 2 ports. We have the Ethernet. We have an output plug right here where we could hook up speakers. We have the HDMI and we have the power input, and right here is where you put the mini SD card. We're going to set this up for the Raspbian operating system. We're going to put it on this mini SD card right here. What I'm going to show you on here is the easiest way to do it. There are two different methods to install the software on a Raspberry Pi. I'm going to tell you at the end of this video which one I like best.
I've taken you to the Raspberry Pi website, and we're going to go to downloads. And there's two ways that we could do that. We could actually put the Raspbian operating system on the mini SD card, or we could put the Noobs program on there, which is actually new out-of-the-box software, which is actually an easier way of installing the software. And let's take a look at this. See, there's a Noobs Lite and a Noobs, and we could download the zip file onto there. But before we get to that, I want to show you the Raspbian also. This is a good way to do it. This is how I did it with another program called Etcher. It's a free program that allows you to make your SD card a bootable device. But anyway, this is available for you to do if you feel more comfortable with it and you are more experienced with installing software. For our purposes here, we're going to use the Noobs software and place that on our SD card so we can install it easily. Well, if you haven't used these before, you have the SD, full-size SD, and the mini SD. You just place it in there, like so. All right, and then you stick it in your SD card reader in your computer. If you don't have an SD card reader in your computer, you could pick up one of these. They're real cheap. This is an Insignia. I got this at Best Buy for about $5. You can put your SD card right in here, this way. It shows you how to put it in, and then you put it in your USB slot. It's that easy. We're going to download the zip file. Just click on download, and we're going to put it on the desktop for you. There we go. I've been calling this a mini SD card. It's actually a micro SD card. But anyway, the reason it took so long to download was because it is 1.6 gigabytes. What you want to do is put this into your computer, and like I said, if you don't have an SD card slot, use one of these and plug it into your USB. You're going to have to format it for FAT32 once you put it into your SD card reader. Just to be on the safe side, we're going to use the formatter that the Raspberry Pi website recommends, and I'll show you how to get there. You want to go to this website here, SD formatter 4, but actually it's up to 5, so I'm going to bring it up on the next tab right here. And we're going to come down here. We're going to download it for Windows. Okay, it's pretty simple. We want to format H. It has H up here. Quick format. And we'll click that. And we get a warning. You expect that. Okay, file system FAT32. Okay, what we're going to do is extract all. We're going to extract it onto the desktop again. Now, if you have a computer that will not extract something that is as large as 1.6 gigabytes, then there is also a program that you could download from the Raspberry Pi website that will accomplish that task for you. Now, once this is finished, we'll just transfer this over to the SD card. One very important instruction in here is on this README file. Copy the extracted files onto the SD card that you just formatted so that the files are in the root directory of the SD card. Please note that in some cases, it may extract the files into a folder. If this is the case, then please copy across the files from inside the folder rather than to the folder itself. So what we have to do on here, just copy everything on here, hit the shift key while you're holding it down, and just drag this across to the SD card. Okay, now we have all the files in the SD card, and this is what you want to see whenever you're finished with it. You want to see these three folders here and then all these in the root of the SD card. If it extracts into a folder, do not move the whole folder over. Just copy all these and then drag them over. All right, I ejected it and I'm going to place it in the Raspberry Pi. Let's go over to the other camera here. Okay, I'm going to take my mouse and keyboard. That's these two right here. And it doesn't matter which ones you plug it into. You can plug it into any one of the USB slots on here. Now we're going to put in the Ethernet cable right here. We really don't need it, but I'm going to put it in there anyway. We're going to use the HDMI cable for our monitor. Straighten this out a little bit. And finally, the wall wart. 5 volt, 2.5 amps with a on-off switch. Let's turn this thing on to see what happens. So far, so good. We should see a Raspberry up on the screen in a minute or two. What it's doing right now is it's preparing all the files that we downloaded onto the SD card. So this may take a while. Well, it only took about 4 minutes to go through that first step. But what we're going to do, we're just going to click on the first one, Raspbian Full. That's the recommended. Click up here and install. So we want to do that because that's the operating system we want on there. OS installed successfully. It took maybe about 10 minutes. We'll click on it and it looks like it's going to reboot. Okay, before you start, it says there are a few things to press next to get started. Okay, country. And this is a basic thing. You put the country in there, your language, time zone, and we're going to have to find, oh, there it is, New York. Okay. Use US keyboard, that's checked. Next. It's setting the location. Not sure if you actually need it on the other one. I did not
set a password in there. System is up to date. All right. Is now set up and ready to go. Please reboot your Pi for the new settings to take effect. Before I hooked this thing up, I tried to pair the Bluetooth with my cell phone and I couldn't do it. It said it didn't recognize it. So we're going to pull up the Chrome browser here. So we'll wait for the browser to open. Put this in the middle right here. Okay, we're just going to go jmri.org. And there we go. We'll bring up production release and Linux. It's ready to go. We're going to minimize this right here. And we're going to bring our file manager, go to downloads. And you can see that this is our file that we want to unzip. Didn't bring it up yet. Okay, now that we have JMRI there, action, we want to extract. And instead of extracting it into downloads, we're going to extract it into the main directory home Pi. We'll do selected files, extra files, extract. And as long as that's blinking like that, it's working. When it finishes blinking, it'll be finished. Now that it quit blinking, it's finished. So we'll go over here and we'll just refresh this right here. And you can see JMRI right there. Before we start, we want to make sure that we have our command station for DCC++ hooked up with the USB cable. I'm going to put the power to it, you know, the 12 volts on the operating side of it, just in case. We'll go over to Panel Pro. You want to execute and wait for it to open. And once we open it, we'll have to set all the defaults on it and set up the railroad on there. Okay. So the preferences come up automatically. Okay, so what we're going to do, I'm going to go over here, and that sets the default right there, my JMR railroad. But I'm going to put in Leakin Creek. That's the name of my railroad. We'll just see if it comes up on there. So we're going to go DCC++. Right here, we're going to go DCC++ serial port because we have it hooked up with the USB. Serial port, we're going to use ACMO, TTYACMO. Defaults, we can't do anything yet on that until after. We want to perform action and come down here and open our Y throttle server. And again, it puts two of them up there, so we remove one. And what else? Okay. File locations, my JMR railroad, blah, 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 blah. So we'll save and we'll have to reboot or restart. Brings it right back up with the Y throttle. There's our IP address for the Y throttle right there with the port number. We'll bring this back up here in the preferences. Go to defaults and you see service programmer. We're going to need to click that radio, those two radio buttons to make sure that all of these going across are on the DCC++. Save it. I'm going to have to restart it again.
and we'll be good to go to use the throttle. Now, before we use the Y throttle, we're going to use a regular throttle just to make sure it runs. And I have 8432 on there. I'm going to turn it on first. I heard the little click. There's the horn. There's the bell. And you could hear it moving, the bell going while it's moving. We'll put it back in forward. Okay, now that we know that our DCC++ is working, then we'll set it up with the Y throttle. All right, I have my tablet out with engine driver. We'll pull that up. And as you can see, it says Leakin Creek 10.00142 and then 12090 over here. So we're going to click on Leakin Creek, press to select. We have 8432 already on here. So we'll just bring it over to here. All right, now let me do this with the other hand. Okay, so we'll put this on forward, turn the bell on, oops. And I forgot it's off right now. So you can see the red over there, red over here. So we'll just tap it, make it green. Okay, forward, turn the bell on. Horn. Okay, so you know that works. Okay, so we'll go. And I just have the short track right here, so we can't go too far. That's about as far as we can go. So we'll go reverse. Oops. Okay. Light on, light off, we'll turn the power off. Okay, now we'll turn the power off right here, and you can see over there, it just turned it off. And when we turn the power on over here, it'll turn it on our tablet. So we're good to go. We got it running. Like I showed you earlier, there's two different ways that you could put the operating system on. I've used both ways. I've used the noobs, and I've used the Raspbian to burn the image on the SD card with Etcher. Even though they say noobs is the easiest way to do it, in my opinion, doing the Raspbian and using Etcher is a lot easier and a lot faster. There's less setup for it. All you have to do is download Etcher, select the file that you want, select the SD card that you want, let it go. It takes about 5 minutes or less, and you're all set. You plug that into your Raspberry Pi. It doesn't take that long for it to set up, and you still have to go through the same setup process once it starts and reboots. So it's up to you which way you want to go. I showed you the noob's way, and I'll also show you the Raspbian way in another video. It's not that hard. It takes about maybe 5-10 minutes altogether. So until next time, we'll see you.